Hey, if you watch our channel, Above God's Name, and you watch our videos regularly, you realize that I demonstrate over and over and over how much spirits are actually far more involved in our day-to-day activity than we would even begin to realize. And those spirits are working to take the King James Bible and to move it out of the realm of the King James Bible in your mind into the realm of the King James Version. I'm going to explain this to you today on Above God's Name. The reason we don't realize that these spirits are so active and involved in the things in our environment to get into our minds is because they camouflage themselves very well. And we're going to look at this today. Bible versions decoded. Now, this man is blending right in. We're going to identify him as the RV. That's the Revised Version. It came out in the year 1881. And here's the NIV blending in, the New King James Version blending in, and the ESV blending in. We're going to find out what they're really trying to blend into. Now, I want to start by saying that KJV is incorrect. To say King James Version is incorrect. Now, that begs the question, if you watch my channel or you've read my book, so why do you use it? Because I do use it, and I do say KJV on occasions. I do say King James Bible on occasions. And the reason I do so is knowingly that I'm doing so, not in an ignorant state. The answer is, according to my conviction, 2 Corinthians 5:20, where we are described as ambassadors of Christ. And I use King James Version when speaking on occasions because it is an ambassador word. We have to bring those who are in another camp ruled by spirits, not the Holy Spirit, into the proper standing with the Lord. And at times it's necessary to use this for their understanding's sake. So it's a merciful term to use. As long as one understands clearly in standing rightly before the Lord that we ought not, technically speaking, to identify it this way. And we're going to get into this reason why, because there's an absolute spiritual agenda in bringing the King James Bible into this realm known as the King James Version. So KJB is correct, and the KJB, King James Bible, is technically a translation and not a version. Now let's move on here. This is the glorious title page of the 1611 King James Bible, and I just want to show you how it is self-identifying as the Bible, not a version. So we have its title page stating, quite frankly, the Holy Bible. So that would mean it's the King James Bible. Now, when it does this, it's very non-apologetic in its approach, just like the way God introduces himself in Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God. No apologies, no explanation. He just appears in all authority. That's what's taking place on the title page of the King James Bible. The authority of the Word of God is on the scene. And of course, here with Anno Dom 1611, it's identifying itself not only as the King James Bible, but with those very important numbers, 1611, the year of our Lord, 1611. And we see in my videos all throughout the King James Bible that magnificent 1611 structure that God has raised the King James Bible to have in its engineering. Now, I personally have not found anywhere in the 1611 where it identifies as a version. If I am wrong and I have not seen something, feel free to let me know exactly where I will look that up. But my research is always seeing it identifying, self-identifying as a translation. So let's begin to take a look at this. Bible versions decoded. The first thing we need to do is we need to note the difference between a translation and a version. So we will start with a translation. Now I've put this definition together. A translation is a change where in an entity, it converts from one natural state into a differing natural state. So I'll explain that by giving you examples. But first, let's take note that the King James Bible uses the words translate, translated, and translation. And each usage of the above is always going from an inferior condition into superior condition. So when the King James Bible self-identifies as a translation, it is stating, according to the internal defining of translate, translated, translation, that it is taking a maturity, a greater condition than its predecessor. Now, here's examples of what a translation would be. From Hebrew into Greek. That would be such as Old Testament verses that are being re-quoted in the New Testament in Greek. From Hebrew into English, that's an example of a translation. From Greek into English, that's an example of a translation. Because remember, a translation goes from one natural state, such as Hebrew or Greek, into a differing natural state. And that would be English. So from Hebrew to English, there is a difference of nature. That's critical to understand, all right? We'll continue now. Translation, meaning versus version, meaning. We'll go on to a version. A version is a change wherein an entity converts from one condition into another condition within the original natural state. Now, the KJV never uses the word version. Isn't that interesting? Here's an example of a version. From English into differing English. So here's one condition, English. And when it goes into a differing English, there's another condition. Both of these are within the original natural state, which is English. That's a version. So, therefore, if these modern day Bibles that are spirit led, and I don't mean the Holy Spirit, but the spirits that lead them, by harnessing men who reportedly and said so want to give you a better translation, then why do they all name themselves with a V for version, such as RV, the Revised Version, or NIV, the New International Version, or the NKJV? Shouldn't they all of these here that I have listed, shouldn't they all end with a T instead of a V if their real goal is to bring you a better translation? But that's not what they're doing. And they're telling you this right up front in your face, but you don't see it. And they know you don't see it. The men who produce these Bibles, the Bible publishing houses, they don't realize what they're doing. They don't see it because they're under the control of spirits. Their minds are under this amnesia type control to do as they are led by these spirits. So shouldn't all of these be the instead of NIV, NIT, or the ESV, shouldn't it be the EST translation if that's really their goal, to bring you a better Bible? But they don't do it, do they? Look at They all have version, all the way down to the recovery version. Shouldn't it be the recovery translation? Well, absolutely so. But these spirits have an agenda, and that's what we're exposing and decoding today. They are camouflaging an attack against the King James Bible. And that is why they all end in V. Remember, a version is a change wherein an entity converts from one condition into another condition within the original state, natural state. And that would be within the same language. So anything going from English into a differing English is a version. So this proves that they're not really bringing you a better translation, but their hidden agenda, camouflaged, is to attack the King James Bible's English. So from God's King James Bible English into man's NIV English, you have truly, as they're confessing, these spirits are confessing a version. From God's King James Bible English into man's ESV English, they are confessing that they are doing nothing other than attacking the King James Bible. From God's King James Bible English into man's New King James Version English, going against English. Not a better translation, but a camouflaged attack on the King James Bible. That is the goal right there. It's all in the letters, defined for you, if you take the time to learn what is happening. They must apparently show you and identify themselves for some strange reason, because they're always doing it. They always expose themselves, but you have to pay attention. Now, here's it mapped out, this camouflaged attack against the King James Bible, and we're going to see something amazing. So watch this closely. Here's your Hebrew Old Testament and your Greek New Testament. The King James Bible is identifying as a translation. This is the truth. But over here, all of these V's that are identifying as a version are using this right here, the Hebrew and the Greek, as a camouflaged cloak. If this was their true purpose and their true intent, then these all would not be V's. They would be T's for translation. But this is only a camouflaged cloak. Really, what is taking place, unbeknownst to you, is this right here. This multi-streamed, multi-arrowed attack against the King James Bible. That's what's happening. Now watch. Here is the word version. And here are many versions. And all of these versions, all they're doing is, in military terms, what they call running noise to confuse the opposition. That would be the attempt to confuse those who would find God's words, the King James Bible. See, version backwards, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed, the scriptures say. N-O-I-S-E, noise. These are all running noise against the King James Bible to confuse you. Now look, these spirits are running interference. This attack is noise, which equals interference, to interfere with your faith. So powerful what the Lord can reveal to us if we are willing to confess. Spirit-led Bibles. Now, I want you to know well that 5 is the number of death in the scriptures. Just look at this. Genesis chapter 5, the death roll call. Adam dies in verse 5 at the 5th mention of his name. Seth dies at 5th mention of his name. Enos dies at 5th mention of his name. Canaan dies at the 5th mention of his name. Mahalaleel dies at the 5th mention of his name. Jared dies at the 5th mention of his name. Then Enoch breaks the death spell because he was taken up. Methuselah back to dying at the fifth mention of his name. And Lamech dies at the fifth mention of his name. All of this is just some examples that five is the number of death in the scriptures. So what do we have also revealed to us by the Holy Spirit? These spirits want the King James Bible to be a KJV, because Roman numeral V equals five, and that equals death. And they want you to pronounce a death spell upon the words of God. But they carry the death spell, because the RV, the NIV, the NKJV, the ESV, the ERV, the EHV, the MEV, the RSV, the NRSV, the CEV, the ASV, the ISV, the Recovery Version, they all are expressing that they have the spirit of death, because they do not source from God, and God is life. He is the life. What does not source from him can only be death. Natural chaff, chaff dried up, death. V, Roman numeral V, five, death in the scriptures. So, are you ready to confess? Are you ready to confess that the King James Bible is the words of God? Or would you rather cleave in these last days with these spirits that are foul, that have the stench of death? It's unbelievable that today's generation of the Laodicean church will hold on and clutch these Bibles to their grave. No wisdom, no knowledge, no insight, illumination by the Spirit. And when shown, when the light is shown and shined upon their so-called Bibles, still they do not repent, because they're destined to fall.